Though Jesus was the Son of God, life for him and his parents was not easy. Let us look at one major dangerous situation in the life of Mary, Joseph, and Jesus.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear sisters and brothers in Jesus Christ, today we are celebrating the fifth day of our novena service to our Blessed Mother. And so let us continue to thank God for the gift of our Blessed Mother to each one of us. Today is also the first Friday of the month. We remember the Sacred Heart of Jesus, who loves us immensely and who also teaches us to love others. Today we also celebrate the memorial of Saint Gregory the Great, Pope and Doctor of the Church. As we take part in the Eucharist, let us thank God for all these occasions. Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who care for your people with gentleness and rule them in love, through the intercession of Pope Saint Gregory, endow, we pray, with the spirit of wisdom, those to whom you have given authority to govern, that the flourishing of a holy flock may become the eternal joy of the shepherds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Colossians. Christ Jesus is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For by him all things were created, in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible. Whether thrones or dominions or rulers or authorities, and he is before all things. And in him all things hold together. And he is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in everything he might be preeminent. For in him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, all through him to reconcile to himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, making peace by the blood of his cross. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, come before the Lord, singing for joy. Kindly listen to the tune.
Together.
Come before the Lord, singing for joy.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, and the earth serve the Lord with gladness. Come before Him, singing for joy. Our response. Know that He, the Lord, is God. He made us, we belong to Him. We are His people, the sheep of flock. Our response.
Come before the Lord, singing for joy.
Enter His gates with thanksgiving, and His courts with songs of praise. Give thanks to Him and bless His name. Our response.
Come before the Lord, singing for joy.
Indeed, how good is the Lord, eternal His merciful love. He is faithful from age to age. Our response. Kindly rise for the gospel. Of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will have the light of life.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now after they had left, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up, take the child and his mother, and flee to Egypt, and remain there until I tell you, for Herod is about to search for the child to destroy him." Then Joseph got up, took the child and his mother by night, and went to Egypt, and remained there until the death of Herod. This was to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet, "Out of Egypt I have called my son." The Gospel of the Lord.
Jesus Christ.
Kindly be seated. We have two children here, Shalom, who did the readings, and Michelle, who did the introduction, and she will be doing many other parts of the service. Do you all remember what was yesterday's theme? You all watched the online mass. What was yesterday's theme? Yes. Yes, the presentation of Jesus in the temple. And what is the theme of today's Mass? Shalom. Correct. The flight into Egypt by Joseph, Mary, and also Jesus. I have personally made this journey from Israel to Egypt. And that journey I made by bus. And that journey took me 10 hours to reach from Israel to Egypt. And when I finally reached there, I had gone along with a group. And not only I, but all of us, when we finally reached Egypt, we were exhausted and tired. So every time I read this passage of the flight to Egypt, I'm amazed how Mother Mary and Joseph and Jesus traveled in those days from Bethlehem to Egypt. And I can imagine the hardships that they went through, because in this journey there are several hardships that one comes across. For example, the weather is extremely hot because there is desert along the way. Then there could have been sandstorms. Then besides that, there could also be dacoits, villains who will hide and then attack you. So the journey that Mary and Joseph and Jesus undertook was not a simple journey. At least we went by bus, but they must have traveled on the back of a donkey. It took us 10 hours to reach there. They must have taken at least more than a month to reach that particular place. So there were a number of hardships that they went through. But one of the most important hardships that probably they went through is that the soldiers of Herod were chasing them. Soldiers of Herod must have been chasing them on horsebacks. They may be wanting to catch them and arrest them. And in this regard, there is a traditional story, a legend told. We do not know how true it is. But we are told that since the soldiers of Herod were chasing Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, they were really tired and exhausted. And they decided to take shelter in a cave. And so they found one cave and took shelter over there. But they knew that the soldiers were following them. So as they entered inside that cave, Mother Mary found two spiders inside that cave. And immediately she told Joseph to be quiet for a while. And then she spoke to these two spiders. She told them that you are creatures made by God. You are creatures made by God. And I have God in my hand. Jesus was with her. I have God in my hand who has created you. Today we are in need of your help. We do not have anybody, any friends over here to help us. The only ones who can help us is you. So please come to our help and save us from the soldiers of Herod who want to kill us. That is the request and humble prayer that Mary made to those spiders. And then we are told that finally the soldiers of Herod reached that particular cave after some hours, and they took a torch and they entered into that cave in order to search Mary, Joseph, and Jesus. And as they were searching with that torch, they entered right in. And then Mary, Joseph were full of fear. They were afraid because they heard the footsteps of their soldiers coming near to them. They did not know what to do. But then suddenly that soldier who was frantically searching them, he stopped. He told the other soldiers, the main soldier, he told the other soldiers to stop. He said, I don't think so they have come here, because there is a complete cobweb in this cave. If Mary, Joseph and Jesus had come here to hide, then this cobweb would have been broken. But this cobweb is unbroken. So I don't think so they have come here. Let's go back. And so we are told that these soldiers went back, they retreated without going inside that cave. And after these soldiers had gone back, after an hour or so, Mary, Joseph and Jesus came out, and they found that there was a cobweb there that had protected them that particular day. And that cobweb was done by the spiders. So the spiders had protected them that particular day. My dear sisters and brothers in Jesus Christ, what lesson do we learn from this theme or this topic of today, flight of Mary, Joseph and Jesus into Egypt? What is an important lesson we learn from this theme? We must remember that besides facing several hardships, I told you that they had to face that hot weather, they had to travel on a donkey's back, they had to face sandstorms, they had to face dacoits, they had to face the soldiers of Herod. But once they reached Egypt, you must also remember that they had come into a strange land. The people there were not of their type. They had come into a strange land, they had come into a strange culture, they had come into a strange religion. We do not know how those people treated them. But they had to survive. They had to live in that place. They had to go to that strange place and adjust themselves. So what is an important lesson that you learn from this particular story? Michelle, do you learn any important lesson from this story that you can practice in your day-to-day life? Remember that Mary, Joseph and Jesus were strangers in that land of Egypt. So what lesson do you learn from this? Shalom. Any lesson you learn? Yes, Michelle, tell me. Okay, we have to face our hardships. All right. What other lesson do you learn? Think you are studying in school, no? Is there a situation like this can come in your life? Sometimes you must remember that there are children who come from other schools in your school, no? They take admission in your particular school. They are new to that school. So you must make them welcome, no? You must not treat them like strangers. You must make them welcome, you must make them loved and feel wanted, and help them in whatever way you can. So also sometimes suddenly in our neighborhood we see new people coming. So we must go all out to help them, because we know that God lives in strangers. God comes to us through strangers, through migrants, through refugees. So we must always be welcoming and always give them our love and our attention. So as we take part in Eucharist, let us pause for a while. And remember the times when we have not been very welcoming and accommodating to strangers who came into our life. And if we have been accommodating and welcoming to strangers in our life, let us thank God for that wonderful gesture. Let us now rise and place before God our prayers and petitions. God does make a way where there seems to be no way. With faith and confidence, therefore, we come once again to place our petition, saying, Father of all, hear our prayer. Together, Father of all, hear our prayer.
For Pope, Bishop, Priest and clergy, that they may always stand for justice and the right of those who are marginalized and discriminated against. We pray.
Father of all, hear our prayer.
For social workers, that they may continue to find the strength and inspiration to reach out to the lost and the last of society. We pray.
Father of all, hear our prayer.
For our SSEs, that we may become truly inclusive and embracing of people from all background, caste, greed and orientation, we pray.
Father of all, hear our prayer.
For migrants and refugees, that they may find hope and courage and not despair in tough situations, we pray.
Father of all, hear our prayer. We pause for a while and pray for our personal and local needs. Our response, Father of all, hear our prayer. Give us, O Lord, the same strength which you blessed Mary with to face the trials and sufferings in our life. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Grant our supplication, we pray, O Lord, that this sacrifice we present in celebration of Saint Gregory may be for our good, since through its offering you have loosed the offenses of all the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Gregory the Great, you bid your church rejoice, So too strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oswald, our Bishop, his auxiliary bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Gregory the Great, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us make our spiritual communion with the Lord. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Through Christ the teacher, O Lord, instruct those who feed with Christ the living bread, that on the feast day of Saint Gregory they may learn your truth and express it in works of charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Novena prayer to Our Lady of the Mount. O Mary, Mother of Jesus, we honor you and thank you for the countless blessings we have received through your intercession with your divine Son, Jesus. As you are the Queen and Mother of Mumbai, we humbly implore you to keep our city safe from all dangers, troubles, calamities, and all evil. Let there be peace, goodwill, and understanding among all communities in India and the whole world. Keep our families united in mutual love and obtain for us the following favor. Amen. prayer for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayer we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for an efficacious control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We thank you for blessing the efforts of our research scientists working on the development of a vaccine. We pray that these vaccines will be effective in combating the virus and its mutants, and in controlling the spread of the pandemic. We pray that the vaccine be available for all our people, even the poor and those in rural areas. We pray for doctors, nurses, and health workers who are in the front line of this battle, that they be kept safe and have the strength and courage to continue their heroic efforts. We pray for the governments and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please be seated for a while. My dear people and my dear children, once again it is time to announce a competition of the Marian Knight. And I'm happy to announce the third competition of our Marian Knight, which is to draw a picture of our Mother Mary. And it can also be sketched, it can be painted, so you can use all your creativity. And though this competition is meant for children, even others who wish to participate are most welcome. So once you are ready with your picture drawn with your own hands, you can send us an image of your picture on our WhatsApp number 8169875316, together with your name and your zone, latest by 5th September at 6 p.m. And as usual, the first three places will get good prizes. So children, I wish to encourage you to kindly take part in this competition. I know most of you like to draw, like to paint. And this being a Marian night, a night dedicated to our Blessed Mother, I think all the more you should take part in this competition and also encourage others. At the same time, all those who wish to even send in the entries of the mascot as well as the 1 minute video singing a hymn to our Blessed Mother are still free and welcome to do so. Kindly rise for the final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.